Okay. As I stated before, I want to be able to draw and capture the movement and the travel of everything going on. So like, if I take a particular direction instead of another direction, the light that leads up that way is what I want to learn to be able to capture. I want to draw what it's like going down steps, up steps, what you see when you're going down steps and which way your body is moving from another direction. You know, the glare on cars, like being able to draw all of that with a acrylic pen, I think they're called Posca or Posca, and just being able to draw in between each one and what it looks like when you are walking from one angle of direction, like what you see from that angle, like what the bridge looks like if I'm right here. You know, being able to draw all that. So if I know that that's something that's my goal, if that's what I'm setting my goal to be, then it's important for me to practice those skills, like the intricate skills of like how to draw dust on the car, how to draw shadows, how to draw surroundings and stuff like that. And then once I find a way for me to master how I'm able to draw that, that's when I will be able to potentially teach others. Just what things look like from a certain angle. Like what the cars look like when they're turning around the corner and stuff. I mean, this area is okay, but it doesn't really get to the detail as much as I want, other than from the cars. Like the details on the cars, is like if I was to draw this right here, I would emphasize like what the cars are looking like, instead of like the actual street per se. But my expertise, my focus, my major would be like the outside surroundings, like the actual street, the drains, the shadows from the trees. Like being able to draw that stuff, yes, but also combining different media, just like a sketch pad, like a mixed media kind of painting, where it's like I am doing the like the drawing. Like I do want to learn how, like let's say I have two different versions where one I just drew it all, and then another one I painted it, used watercolor, different paints. Like my ideal piece, or not my ideal piece, but my signature piece would be watercolor paint, acrylic paint pens, fine point markers, colored pencil, and crayons. Like mixing all of that all together to, because it really shows like the texture. Like when you use different tools to create your piece, it adds texture to it. So I feel like using different tools will help me be able to capture the entire essence of a neighborhood, you know? Like every single part. Like the balcony and what things look like from farther distances. Like if the distance is this far, I want to be able to capture all of this from this building, and also where I actually be at, because when I be walking, I be directly in the street, you know? And so, like, I would want to be able to capture the entire essence of what the angles look like from where I am in the direction I'm coming. So, like, when I was walking the other way up this street, you know, I was walking the other way to get to the supermarket. So it's a completely different angle. It's completely different shadows than when I'm walking from the other angle. So, like, this is a good, like, idea. Like, a good exercise for all artists, especially artists who draw and create surroundings and environments, who's the expertise and major is that, is to go outside and actually look at the stuff you want to draw. It's just like watching a YouTube video to kind of see and capture different angles and stuff like that. So, like, the car wash, feel me? And actually being able to slow things up, you know, like the different angles across the street, like, because I want to show not only just from right here, but like the angle, like the different angles, like all that's going on in a neighborhood and in an environment. Where each of these will be like an actual sketch, you know? So from this angle and, you know, like the community kind of vibes of like what it's like to go up and down different directions, different stores, and the reflections in cars, and the brightness and the shininess of stores, clothing, and the different like angles of like birds and chickens and shit like that. This is just an artist exercise for me to be able to draw and learn how to see from different angles. Like the color contrast between like a red car and the red beak or face of like a chicken. I would want to draw certain things because I've seen it in my environment. You know? So, I'm gonna go where I usually walk, which is like in the middle of the street. You know? And just being able to draw every little intricate piece of like even inside of this building, like drawing from the different angles, shades of glass, awe of the ceiling and like what it looks like to be on the outside of this building and be able to see everything that's going on inside of the building, from the ceilings inside of the building. You know, like that's a perspective you can draw. And just like you can draw certain parts kind of blurry and other parts focused, being able to master that as well. The brightness and the colors of like different signs and what it looks like from a particular angle. Graffiti on the buildings, the reflections on the cars. This is a good angle. This is a good practice for like the details, because it has a lot of details. From the very top of this building and all the intricate marks and designs and pieces that just so happen to come with age, but can still look and come together like as a beautiful painting. The red of the pizza, the green, you know, like with the yellow. But yeah, this is good practice for painting storefronts and stands. Like being able to draw every little piece and mark, even like what it looks like for a person to reach their hand and reach for something, with the shadiness of the darkness of the store looks like versus the brightness of when you're close to what's outside the store and what stores have inside of them as well. Like the prices, suitcases, luggage, sunglasses, and like the new decoration and building. Somebody holding a certain speaker. Sometimes you can see the speakers. And then there's other kind of stores that is outside. You know, they bring their things outside. Like being able to draw and paint this, like as a portrait. Even to the detail of a cigarette in somebody's hand as they're walking past. You know. Está bien.
No me de esto porque, hey, no a mí, te lo rompo. Oye,
te lo rompo. But even like the purple with that red, with the yellow, for the school bus. And the laundry on a balcony. Like, this is the street I came down before. When I came this way, when I was like really inspired. I like it more from this angle though. When I'm coming up this street and I could see from this angle. So we're gonna go down the the plaza and just kind of focus on the stands, like the, I forgot the word for like when people are outside and they sell different stuff. But I just kind of wanted to like show the angle of the difference between the stores. Some stores got they door open all the time. Some stores got their door closed all the time. Some stores don't have a door at all, you know? So. Contrast of colors. What should I like to see? Am I what it looks like real, real close like this? Like it's only certain angles you can even get if you're not even a certain level of close or willing to use a certain level. Some stores got stuff inside. But mostly all of the stores got their doors open. And if the store door is closed, they probably got air conditioning. But yeah, like doing videos is cool. Like I really fuck with videography and photography and stuff like that, especially when it comes to angles. But like being able to recapture that by drawing it or painting it is like a whole new experience. Wow, that's cool. Like a whole thing of art supplies. I see that.
Anticipation is building. The holidays are just around the corner, and at the Home Depot, we can't. With Black Friday savings all through November, you can count down to Christmas
like
early
being able
with a Santa countdown and
capture.
Visit a special buy. Friends and family come to visit with an entrance full of LED light to welcome them and the holidays.
This store got air conditioned, even though the doors is wide open. But the store is kind of big and it goes back really far. So you can feel like the AC. Even from right here, you know. Even like the bees on the garbage can, like being able to draw all of that, like every intricate piece, even the facial expressions of people when they're looking at you, and outfits too, like. Like, I really like this shirt that this man has on. This is, like, kind of my style. But, like, and it looks cool.
Meses después.
Possibly be occupied soon, or maybe that person is on break, or maybe they didn't work today, or maybe it's available for somebody to use. So like, I'm kind of seeing this all from a perspective as if it's my first time seeing all this, when I don't walk past stuff plenty of times. But just seeing from like different angles, you know, this is cool. So like, this is just my first little go around today. I'm really, really, really hungry right now. So I'm gonna come back. Also wanna pay for my phone bill. So I'm gonna do that as well. But yeah, this is just like I said, this is an art perspective. I mean, art exercise for me to learn how to draw everything I'm seeing, everything I'm looking around at, and everything I'm being like I'm seeing right now. Like, environmental artist or something, like a surroundings artist, just being drawing every little part and piece, like the balcony. It's good to like get certain angles of things that you haven't seen before. I mean, that you have seen before. Buena. But I like that, even though I haven't been outside playing my trombone in a long time, people still kind of remember me out here playing. It's kind of cool. I want to master my craft a lot better from like a private space, you know? And I feel like it relates and correlates to drawing a lot as well. Like me drawing all of these surroundings, and then being able to draw myself in those surroundings as well, playing the trombone in the middle of the street, on the sidewalk and stuff. But yeah, just drawing from every single angle. Like, every single angle. And capturing every little part. I didn't say that actually, but just not being afraid to capture certain surroundings and be a photographer, because